Kazoukas, a representative for the Greek Federation of Professional Firefighters, is joining us now from Athens. Thank you, Vasilis, for joining us today. Now, we saw harrowing images and we've heard those harrowing stories. Can you tell us what your experience was like battling that blaze and finding survivors and some of the dead?
We believe now it's not the time to describe stories. We focus on the human side and everything that is needed from now on to reduce the impact mitigation of this catastrophe. And what are the next steps in order to not have in the future situations like this?
So what is ahead for you? Sorry, go ahead.
For me, it's time now to evaluate the basis of the mechanism for forest fire protection. It was a very difficult fire. It was a massive fire with high winds. Even the direction of the wind make the whole operation more difficult because the area have many dead end roads. And all this, at the end, made a big catastrophe, tragedy for the Greek nation, which shows in every way the solidarity to the victims and their families.
Yeah, so Vasilis, you know, today we were talking about the continuing rescue efforts. And so looking ahead, what do you still have to do after, you know, the rescue operations end?
There's still a big operation in progress in order to find every victim, and we will not finish until we find every missing person. That is our primary goal. After this, we will discuss what went wrong, what we could do to have better results.
All right.
If we could do something to have better results.